All right, so let's talk a little bit about the C/Linux memory model. So this is a picture of a memory address space for a process. So every process that is running on the system has its own virtual address space, and we'll define some of these terms a little more rigorously later on this semester. But for now, you can think of this as all the memory in the system. So from address 0 down here at the bottom all the way up to the highest address in the system. And so for now, we're just going to pretend that every process has its own exclusive access to all of memory. So that's what we mean by address space, just this large portion of memory where a process can store data and code. There are a bunch of different regions in this address space. So you can see some of the regions here. These are not all of the regions, but these are sort of the more important ones that we'll be talking about this semester. So there is a static code region, a static data region, a heap, and a stack. So some of these regions are static, meaning that they don't change size while the program runs. But others, like the stack and the heap, are dynamic, meaning that they can grow and shrink while the program is running. So the stack region expands whenever a function is called. So there's a region on the stack for every function that is currently running. And whenever the function returns, that portion, the portion of the memory that was allocated for that function is deallocated. The heap region grows and shrinks whenever you ask for memory, so whenever the programmer allocates memory or deallocates memory explicitly. Some of these regions begin at a randomized location every time the program runs, and this is generally for security reasons. So in C, global variables and static local variables are generally placed inside of the static data region. Local variables to functions are stored on the stack inside of that region that is allocated for each invocation of the function. And then any dynamically allocated memory is stored in the heap. Generally, we can store data that we know the fixed size of in static data and on the stack. And anything that we don't know the size of in advance, we're going to store on the heap. So this is called dynamic memory allocation. This is what you were doing with new, the new keyword in Java, except that now we're going to have to explicitly deallocate it as well as allocate it. So in C, we allocate memory on the heap using the malloc function or one of its derivatives, one of which is called calloc, which we'll be using this semester. Calloc explicitly initializes all the memory to 0, and it helps us to fix bugs a little more easily. You pass malloc or calloc the number of bytes that you need. You usually calculate this using the size of operator so that you're not having magic numbers hard-coded throughout your program. And then the function returns a pointer to the beginning of the allocated region. So for instance, you might tell malloc, I want space for 4 integers. And malloc will return to you an integer, or return to you a pointer to an integer, which is the first memory address of that space that you asked for. And the important thing here is that you are responsible for deallocating the memory when you're done with it, and you do that using the free function. You just have to pass free the pointer to the beginning of the region that you want to deallocate. There's a good coding practice, which is that as soon as you free using a pointer, you immediately set it to null. And this is good for catching bugs, because if you attempt to use that memory location after you've deallocated it, you will get a seg fault right away rather than continuing to use whatever value was stored in that memory, which is now invalid after you deallocated it. If you forget to deallocate memory, that is what's called a memory leak, and we are going to be checking for that in the projects in this course. And your goal is to have no memory leaks in your program. So to summarize, these are the different types of variables in C, and some notes about their address, their scope, and their lifetime. So we have global variables, which are they have a static address, so they are allocated in some particular place in memory and they never move. They have global scope, meaning that they can be changed and accessed anywhere in the program. And they have static lifetime, meaning that they are allocated for the entire duration of the program. In contrast to global variables, we have local variables, which you're used to from Java, which are located on the stack, so they have an address that's on the stack. They are only in scope or visible inside of the function definition, and they have dynamic lifetime, meaning that they are allocated when the function begins executing, and they're deallocated when the function finishes executing. There are also special local variables that can be declared static. So if you have a variable inside of a function that's declared static, this does not change its scope, meaning it's still only visible inside of the function. However, it does change the address and the lifetime. So if you have a static local variable, it is now going to be allocated in a static data segment, just like global variables. And just like global variables, it's also going to have a static lifetime, meaning it's going to be valid for the entire execution of the program. So it's very similar to global variables, but it's like a global variable that only has local scope. And this is useful for communicating between multiple invocations of a function. And then finally, there's dynamically allocated memory, which is located on the heap. So it has an address that's in the heap. It has a local scope, meaning it's only accessible wherever you have a pointer to that variable. And it has a dynamic lifetime, meaning it's valid from the time that you malloc it until the time that you free it. The pointers themselves, and here's a distinction, so the memory that you allocate on the heap and the pointer to that memory are actually two different variables. And in fact, the pointers themselves are usually local variables, just regular local variables. And so that's kind of an important distinction to make.